मैंने नहीं तो फैन ओवर लाएंगे नहीं
सर. नमस्कार धीरेन्द्र सर. नमस्कार.
नमस्ते नमस्ते सर. नमस्ते. गुड इवनिंग ऑल.
गुड इवनिंग सर. वेरी वेरी वेलकम टू द वर्ल्ड साड़ी फाउंडेशन एड्स इंटरव्यू.
यस
वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू कंडक्ट योर इंटरव्यू टुडे. धीरेन्द्र एकबोटे सर इज अ वेरी ग्रेट पर्सनालिटी बिलोंग टू अवर साड़ी कम्युनिटी. वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू बी विथ यू सर हियर.
वैल्यूम वैल्यूम सर.
Yes, Apana. Your phone is not. You are not audible. Aparna, please. Yeah. Yes.
Good evening, sir. And a very warm
very
welcome
evening,
to everyone. I am Aparna Nimkar. I welcome you all in the live forum arranged by WSF. WSF is an organization or a foundation established on 29th October 2017. For all Sali and sub-Sali community. This is having a very great motto in mind, that is to eradicate poverty from this community. Mr. Vijay Narayan Vakte and Mrs. Nisha Vijay Vakte are the main founder of this foundation. I greet everybody, good evening, and I have a pleasure to welcome our celebrity today, our main chief guest today, that is Mr. Dhirendra Ekbote sir. He is a secretary of the Karnataka Rajya Swakosa Sari Shikshan Samstha, as well as he's a retired principal and a social activist. Sir, very warm welcome to you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you all.
Okay. Varsha ma'am, your question please.
I would like to welcome Ekbote sir, and it's a very great moment for all of us to welcome you here, sir.
Sir, first of all, I'm going to introduce my team, sir. Here in the blue shirt, blue dress, Dr. Aparna Nimkar. She is a psychotherapist, and she is a very great anchor. Behind me,
good.
Mrs. Varsha Pargat, she's from Gujarat, sir. Gujarat Ankleshwar. She's also a great anchor. Yeah. Here is Sau Pratiksha Burde. She's from Thane, sir. Thane, Mumbai. She's very great anchor.
Yeah.
Here in the middle, here Mr. Rajesh Tambre. He's the grand anchor of World Sali Foundation from Navi Mumbai. And Mr. Sanjay Sali. He's from Jalgaon, Bhusawal. Jalgaon Bhusawal. This is the team of Sir World Sali Foundation anchor, and I, Vijay Vakte, the founder of World Sali Foundation, behalf of all the World Sali Foundation parivar family, we warm welcome you, sir, on the platform of World Sali Foundation. This eighth interview.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
I hope we will all enjoy this interview, and all the people who see us definitely enjoy this interview, sir. Once again, sir, welcome to World Sali Foundation.
Okay, thank sir. You, sir. Thank you so much.
Sir, that is what we are welcoming you on this great platform. And as we have just gone through your CV there, we came to know a lot of things about you. So one thing is most important, that whenever the burning candle is there in the mind, the journey starts. And as you retired from the field, which is the field of education, and it is always changing there. And in today's modern world, no one is there rightly thinking about to enter this world of education, because the young ones, they are always fascinated and attracted by the lump sum amount of the salaries that they are getting. But here, that is the exceptional case that we have today, this great educationist, and he had worked long way there to have some same changes in education there. So it is rightly said by Mahatma Gandhi that if you want to see the change, you must be the change. So I think you must have this thought in your mind. So we would like to know about your education and all these things, no doubt, because as it is rightly said once again, that the child is the father of the man. And childhood days are always important for any person who has a desire to do something different from the routine way. So we are really, they are having this thought in the mind that what we can learn from your childhood days, or how this thought process developed from your childhood days.
Thank you, madam. First of all, I thank this World Soli Foundation and World Soli Foundation team. It is not World Soli Foundation. It is not WSF. It is wonderful, super, and fantastic. And this WSF is having a great team. It is not just a team. It is a team of total efficiency achieving men, TEAM, total efficiency achieving men. I thank this World Soli Foundation and the team of that World Soli Foundation for fantastic and wonderful work, so which has been that is a taking up. Madam, myself is Dhirendra Ekbote. I born in the year 1954, and I have come up from a village by name Hosaritti near Hubli. And my village is known for freedom fighting.
Right.
There are many people still now who fought against British people for bringing freedom to India. Really wonderful. That is the village from where so I have brought up. I completed my education from my village itself up to 10th.
Okay.
Up to SSLC. And my father first did not permit to educate, to give a better education. And even then, I tried my level best to take best out of the available resources and get a better education and good education.
Right.
And my family constituted my father, my sister, elder sister, younger sister, and my two brothers who are youngers. Really, we fought for the poverty. We were suffering from poverty and the poverty aided problems. And out of this, so we managed to let it come out. And so we reached this level. Thank you, madam.
So it is what you set an example for other people also, that whatever the resources are available, you should take the advantage of it. I am audible, sir.
Madam?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Sir, I am audible? Yes, that what you set an example for the other people and the young ones, that whatever the resources are there with us, we should work with that instead of complaining for the resources. So that is what the first lesson I can learn from you, sir, that whatever things we should learn from it and we should take it from it. So I would like to know about you more and more things through my friends who are there now asking you some questions. Over to the next question, sir.
Sir, how was your life as a student, sir? And what was the hurdles?
Sir,
how was your life as a student and what was the hurdles?
Sir, my life as a student, it was a mixture of poverty and poverty-aided problems. I suffered a lot in getting education, even in the rural area itself. I completed my education up to, that is SSLC, up to matric in my village. Then for 11th and 12th. So I went to GH College, Haveri. And I opted PUC Arts. Actually, I wanted to go for science course. But because of my disability, and because of there is a frequent there is a movement to the college for practicals and theory, so the periods, etc. So I didn't opt that is science, but I opted that is arts. And even so I had the interest of that is going in for the commerce. There was no commerce course in the college so nearby my village. And inevitably I went for this arts. I studied that is 11th and 12th, that is arts, and then I went to that is JJ College of Commerce. JJ College of Commerce, Hubli, where I completed my BCom in the year 1976. And my that is a life as a student. So I was that is bringing the lunch boxes from my village from by buses, and weekly two times or three times the lunch boxes were missing. And when the lunch boxes were missing, we used to live without food. And that was it became that is habituated. And that was the problem. And even then we could manage and we sustained it. And so whenever that we wanted to buy for our requirements, so that I requested my student friends to buy for me also, because instead of there is wasting that is the money for going to the market for a rickshaw or something, so I wanted to save it. And therefore, so I requested that my student friends, so there is to buy my requirements also, and so they used to help me. And so there anyway, so that I could manage that poverty also. And I came across that hurdles. For the poverty added the problems also.
Oh sir, my God, you face so many problems, sir.
Sir, your video is stopped, sir. Yeah, okay, sir. Sir, I think your internet connection is unstable, sir. Sir, it's mean that you have completed your all education in Hubli. Is it right, sir? Hello? Ekbote, sir?
So, network loading.
Ekbote, sir?
Yes, sir. Net.
It's a problem.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Can you hear me, sir?
Sir.
Yeah. Can you hear me, sir? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, it means that you have completed all your education in Hubli. Sir, it means that you have completed all your education in Hubli, sir. Is it right, sir?
Yes, I completed my BCom graduation from JJ College of Commerce, Hubli, in the year 1976.
And what is the distance between your village and Hubli, sir? What is the distance between these two cities, village?
100 kilometers, sir. 100 kilometers, sir.
Then how you go from your village to the college? You stay there at Hubli?
No, sir, I was residing in a hostel.
Yeah. And after that, after completing your BCom, you have you did your physical education or B.Ed or M.Ed, M.Phil?
No, sir, M.Com. I did my M.Com, sir, PG course.
Yeah, PG course, M.Com, only M.Com. Okay.
I did my M.Com, then PG course.
Okay.
Yeah, sir.
And after that, you got the post of principal or meanwhile, between these, you have done the other jobs? So on the last leg of my service, I got my principal post, sir. Okay. Okay, next, Shoti.
Okay, sir. We heard you are many hurdles in your life studying. Sir, my next question is, how was a beginning of your career? And what was your age that time? Sir, you heard?
Can I repeat my question? Yeah, sir. Yes, madam.
How was your beginning of your career? What was your age that time, sir?
Madam, so immediately after completion my MCOM in the year 1978, I joined my career. So my MCOM result was announced on 19th July 1978. The very next day, I joined this career, the teaching career. And really, I was not interested to join this teaching career. But I was forced to join this course. My family friend, my father's friend, Rachanna Katti, he insisted me, he forced me to join this career. Inevitably, I joined this course. I joined this course because I had some underestimation. Since I am disabled person, students may, there is a some sort of, there is an amusement, they entertainment they get. And so I may not be comfortable in teaching that is platform. And this type of, there is underestimation that is made me to not to join this course, but I was forced. And when I joined this course, when I started, there is a teaching and teaching to the hearts of, there is academic, there is a hearts, there is a students. So I was gaining something, and students started that is loving me, and so there is a, so this boosted me. I joined, so there is in, that is on 20th July, and then I was permanently appointed on 6th February 1979, and then so I started my career with all that is works working with head, heart, and hands.
समझ सकती हूँ आपका जो इमोशंस है वो टीचर होने के नाते. अगला क्वेश्चन
सर, व्हाट वाज एज दैट टाइम एंड व्हेन यू गेट व्हेन यू गॉट मैरिड? सो माय एज वाज 23 सर. 23 सर माय, दैट व्हेन आई जॉइन द टीचिंग करियर. तो पढ़ा सर. यस सर. Sir, when I joined this city, so 1985, sir.
Sir, again, I'm very thrilled and surprised with the struggle that you had. Right from economic problems to the physical problems to the social problems and the social problems from the, you know, education and everything. But I am really saluting you because the achievement you have done will, you know, actually keep all the even able people behind. Number one is that you are a students welfare officer, head of the Department of Commerce. You were also coordinator of internal quality assurance cell, also the principal in your the topmost phase of your life. Yeah. And that shows that your discipline, your hard work, your systematic and strategic planning of life and education. Sir, I'm just curious to know about, like, how you started and the career that you went up and which phase of your career you enjoyed a lot.
Madam, among these the phases which you just presented,
So that is, I enjoyed the first and foremost, that is the office which I had held, is that is a coordinator for NAC, coordinator, that is a internal quality assurance cell. So when I headed this, there is a office, it forced me to, there is a, find some innovative programs. I started working out, that is for academic new programs, and under this, there is a banner of, there is a NAC, internal quality assurance cell, I crafted, I designed some innovative, there is a, academic programs like TEP, teacher exchange program, students exchange program, and then the senior tutorial to juniors, 5 minutes programs, and there is a face it. So these are some innovative programs, there is academic programs which were, there is introduced, crafted and designed and introduced in my college, in and around my college. And all these program, academic programs have been, there is appreciated, highly appreciated by NAC. That is, a NAC is a central office which is a quality, that is assessing, that is the office which is having its head office at, that is Bangalore. And this NAC is assessing the quality, that is performance of all the colleges and all the universities of this India. And apart from this, there is a, the coordinator, that is a NAC. Then so there is a, I very much loved students welfare officer post. In this students welfare officer post, so I had to, there is a, safeguard the interest of the students. And so there's a, there was no work that is in this office, and I used to just keep on this reporting to the head office, and for that, so I was receiving remuneration. For nothing, I was receiving something. For there is nothing, that is, I am getting some remuneration, and there was no hard work at all. And so I thought, so this amount which I am getting in the form of remuneration, this should be invested for the students' welfare purpose. I started, that is, using this remuneration which I received for all the, that is the duration, that is for 4 years which I worked for, as a student welfare officer. I invested, so it is for the purpose of the students, that is establishing a library, that is a students' library, and now it is worth of rupees 2 lakh when I, there is a departed from the college. Great. And these are two, there is a post which there is a, teaching is a routine work, but apart from this teaching, I love this, there is coordinating, there is a quality assurance cell, and this students office welfare officer, there is office. And this, so very much, there is changed my, there is a life. Thank you, madam.
Sir, not only your life, but you have changed so many students' life. You have gave them, you have given them a very beautiful student's life, and they learned a lot from you. Just now you said that your salary was too much than your duties, and you invested that back into planning. And in spite of having the structure given by the board, you made so much of creative changes, a strategic change in the education system, as well as the quality assurance that you said. You have really maintained the name and the dignity of the position. You have really given the quality to the student, to the organization where you held this place, the position. I'm really happy, but I have also one more sub question to this, is that how you came out with this creative ideas?
Madam, so I was very much, that is, friendly and associated with registrar, Karnataka University registrar evaluation. And right. He was an educationist by name Dr. B.C. Patil.
Okay.
He was named as Shikshana Bhishma.
Okay.
And so we, with a great, there is a friendship and a continuous association with this doctor, the Shikshana Bhishma.
Okay.
I got.
We cannot hear you, sir.
No, madam.
Yes, fine.
Yes, with the help of and guidance of this Dr. D.C. Patil, an educationist, I put there is a craft and a draft the innovative programs like teacher exchange program, students exchange program, all these innovative programs. And just I want to brief that is what this teacher exchange program is. Teacher exchange program is an innovative program wherein a teacher who is expertise from the nearby college, he will be invited to our college. Okay. And it is fully a volunteer program. A person who is expertise in cost accounting, he will be invited to my college. And so I will be going to there is some other college to share my expertise. Wow. The theme behind this teacher exchange program is the expertise of a person should not be restricted to his own college, but it should be shared. So among the students of the neighboring college also. And that was the theme, so the backdrop, so in netting this teacher exchange program. Under this, there is a teacher exchange program, whenever an expert person that is from the neighboring college is coming to our college, and naturally students attendance will be more.
Great.
And therefore, the students will be benefited, and the person, the teacher, when I am visiting the nearby college, I will be preparing that is extra, not in a regular course, because it is the question and dignity of his own and the question and dignity of his institution which he is representing. This is how the teacher exchange program is very popular. So in my college as well as that is in and around the district.
Sir, and I would like to
end the program. Yes, madam.
Yes, sir. Carry on.
So another program is there. That is a senior tutor to juniors. Senior tutor to juniors. It is also one of the that is best academic programs which I drafted, wherein senior student, suppose become final year student will be. That is given the task of there is a lecturing for junior class. For example, there is on any topic of his interest, he will be asked to deliver. That is the class or deliver lecture to the there is the class under him, and that was the senior tutor junior. And under this senior tutor juniors, so it is a program where the senior tutors will be given the opportunity of there is sharing his knowledge. And becoming there is expertise in that is becoming there is a lecture in the future course, and that was the senior tutor juniors, and likewise there is academic innovative programs were knit and highly appreciated by NAC.
Sir, yes, in a true sense, you are a leader, because only leader has a foresight, and a leader can see the resources in the humans around them and assign that particular task to these people. So you are really a true leader who is going ahead along with people they are with them. So I'm really thankful and glad to talk to you. Next question, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Rajesh, sir.
Very good evening, sir. Very good evening, sir.
Yes, sir. Your speech is motivate for us.
Thank you, sir.
My small question is, as you had higher qualification grade caliber, you were offered with government job from Canara Bank and also well-known educational institute. What made you take up a job in a college in rural area?
Sir, a person normally that wishes to join and work in cities. So he wants to enjoy luxuries. He wants to enjoy there is many facilities. Where so this we notice and available there is in city colleges, city there is places. But the theme is to work for the villages, because India is made up of villages. Unless and until we upkeep and we there is develop and we bring there is progress in rural areas, we cannot there is bring any change for India. And my guru, Vidya Guru, by name Professor B.F. Yeligar, inspired me, influenced me to work for rural colleges. And though I had an opportunity of joining this Canara Bank, I had received the order. So I was posted for a bank, that is Annigiri branch near Gadag. And I had the opportunity of going for lecture post in cities. And I had the opportunity of going for a government job, assistant chief editor post. It was for four talukas. But I didn't go. The main intention is I should work for rural students. So there's people normally go to cities, but who has to take care of this rural boys, rural students? And therefore, with this intention, and with the intention of Gandhi principles, so unless and until we develop villages, we cannot see any development for rural India. And therefore, I opted to serve the rural area only, and I loved very much, and I had the satisfaction of serving the rural college. So that's for all the 35 years.
Great, sir. Thank you. Really great. Next question.
Once again, I'm coming back to you there. What I learned from you there, that you have the habit of swimming across the current, that normally the people are always going with the flow of the river. But you have maintained throughout your life about that swimming against the current, that is what the changes are there happening in the society because of the people like you. And we are very proud to have today with us. And one thing I want to add here to your character, that you proved that disability is a matter of perception. So that what you also proved over there. A lot of work that you have done there in these fields or education field there. For that recognition is very important. The awards are nothing but they are the pat on the back, and it is always motivating us to go further. And so you were awarded with one of the very prestigious awards like Man of the Year in India in 2009. And then from that, it was an award from an American Biographical Institute. I don't know really about this institute, sir. You can add to it. And another award was that Bharat Shiksha Ratna Award from the Global Society for Health and Education Growth from Delhi. Sir, these two awards are the feather, the cap, whatever you are doing. So can you tell or share something about these awards and your experience when you received these awards?
Yes, thank you, madam. So these awards I got so for my academic works. So I used to attend national and international seminars across the country. So far, I attended around 50 national and international seminars and conferences where I presented my paper on different topics, different subjects, and these institutes from which I got the awards. The representative of these the institutes used to collect the information about the academicians, about their works. And based on my academic works and achievements, these institutes collected and so awarded me. And so I am proud of to receive all these awards. And especially, I highly appreciate my veteran, my wife, Dobote, for supporting for all the success of receiving these awards.
Right, that is what the better half is always playing an important role in one's character, either it is a husband or either it is a wife. Here, so both of them combined together can make a life together. So that's what we know about. Sir, before going to the another question, I would like to ask you one short question. As you are in the field of education, what changes you can suggest for the teachers there? As we, myself is also a teacher, and Pratiksha is also a teacher. So you can add to it, sir. What can we change in the classroom teaching?
Madam, so teaching as per curriculum It is routine.
Yeah, that's why I'm asking.
The present the need of a teacher, and it is a need of the students also.
Right.
We have to, there is a mold the career. We have to mold the career of the students. Right. Apart from that is a delivering, that is a lecture or the lessons as per curriculum. We have to, there is develop some civic sense. We have to, there is add some, so that is, we have to give, deliver for social values.
Right.
In their lives.
Right.
For refinement of the life.
Right.
And so that will be, that is helping, so in future life, and that will be helping, so there is a, while living with the parents, that will be helping, so while living with the people around the student.
Right.
And therefore it is very much required nowadays. We have to, there is a feed some social values, so along with there is a curriculum, which is very much required.
That is why the changes are brought now in the new education policy, is going back to the values and the social values.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Yes. Over to you.
Sir, you are a great teacher, sir. Sir, we would like to know about your memorable moment, you know, in your career, sir.
Madam, so in the course of my career, so I was having an opportunity. I had the opportunity of, that is, joining research. There is a course, MPhil and PhD. And in the year, that is 1999, so I was selected and I was about to debut. But my college students, hello, my college students repeatedly approached my principal, and they were requesting, if Ekode sir goes on deputation, we definitely, so let's get out the admissions and transfer to some other nearby colleges, and we won't continue here. Because of him, that is, we are learning here, and we are admitted here. And therefore, so unless and until, that is, Ekode sir is here, we won't, that is, stay here. And that was the, that is, objection from the student side. And then, so the principal called me. So this is the problem from the student's end. So how you react for their requirement, their need? And in front of the, that is, principal, students, and that is, between us, so there's a student and myself. So the students outbursted, that is, if you go on deputation, we won't stay here. There is a seek admission somewhere, we get our admissions transferred to, there is some other nearby colleges, and we won't continue here. And so it is a really, I shocked to hear that is words of the students. And so there is a, for a while I started thinking, so MCOM, it is enough for me, MPhil and PhD, so they are added values, qualifications, but the certificate that the students are giving, so appreciation that they are giving, that was enough for me. And therefore it is assured the students, so that I won't go to, that is, a MPhil course, I won't go to, that is, a PhD course, I will retain here only, I will continue. So in the larger interest of you people, I assured. So that was the moment which I cannot, that is, forget. And there is the moment is there, I met my student friend who was working as a district judge in Bangalore on the day of Guru Purnima. I had the opportunity of meeting him, and the motto was to meet him and grace him because he was promoted. So I met him in the court hall in the evening, at about 5 o'clock. And so when I met him, so immediately in the court hall, in the presence of, he's a staff, he touched my feet and saluted. Sirsashtanga Namaskara he gave. And so I was very much shocked. Actually, he should not have done it because it was a court hall. And therefore I requested not to do this one. no sir, so you are my guru. And even there is a, in front of the staff, my there is a student friend, Annayyanavar. He is a district judge. Now he has been transferred to Belgaum. Now he is working there, Belgaumi. So he told his staff, no, no, he is my guru. And because of his grace and because of his there is knowledge, so we could there is a reach this level. He was there is a telling and he was sharing his there is views with his staff. And these two there is moments so were very green in my mind.
It's wow, great Guru Dakshina. It's a Guru Dakshina.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sir, really great, sir. Actually, your entire life is inspiring everyone, sir, who are watching this program. So yeah. Nice, sir. Sir, my question is that how was your journey towards successful career? And what was the role of your better half in your life?
Madam,
sir, may I repeat the question?
So I started my career in the year 1978. I got married in the year 1985. When sir. I got married to Rajeshwari, that is my better off, she completely dedicated for my service.
Wow.
She supported in all respect. He stood by me in all at all the time. So I took the responsibility of family. And he used to go to the post office for a post office work. She used to go to the LIC for payment of the premiums. Besides, there is maintaining the family, and she supported in all respect, and that helped me a lot for working out and to make a journey of success. And I used to work for students while I was working for students. She used to provide regularly at regular intervals tea and tiffin even for students, and I used to teach students during the exam days up to midnight, 3 o'clock and 4 o'clock, and she used to prepare a tea for them. And so that was the support. Yeah, so the type of support she was giving, and I highly appreciate. I am very much love the support that is given by my better off. So therefore there is giving the strength of serving the students, especially in rural area.
Here one person is also joined in this interview session, sir. I think you very well known about him. He is Mr. Marutrao Sakre. He is the trustee of World Sari Foundation, yes, and he is from Adoni, Andhra Pradesh. Now he is joined us from Chandigarh, sir. Mr. Marutrao Sakre. Yes, sir. Yes. Yeah. Okay. Next, please. Yes.
Yeah.
Rajesh, yes, sir. Rajesh, please unmute. Yeah, Rajesh.
Welcome to Maruti Sakre, sir. And my next question is, sir, you have one son and one daughter. What are they doing today? And they impress you or you impress them?
Yeah. Sir, I have two children. One, that is a son and daughter. Son is Narendra. He is MCOM and he is now working for Pune Pradnya College as a lecturer in commerce, Bangalore. And my daughter, there is Nivedita. I purposefully selected these two names. I named Narendra, I named Nivedita. I very much love the life of Swami Vivekananda.
Yes, yes.
So there is a Nivedita.
Narendra.
She completed her PBDM. She is a Chinese school student. She got her a study from Belgaum Chinese school, a Chinese school which is for girls for a whole of India. We have Chinese schools for Bijapur, Chinese school for the boys for somewhere and Kodavu and some other parts of India. But for girls, we have only one Chinese school, that is at Kittur near Belgaum. And she completed her studies up to SSLC. Then she went to BBM, Bangalore. And so after completion of BBM, she went to Ahmedabad from where she completed, that is her PGDM, postgraduate diploma in management. And then, so she joined Societe Generale, so it is a corporate, and now, so she got married and she resigned. So she is a homemaker now. And they have impressed a lot. So there is a, and they are very much a caretaker. So they love and they take care of my all activities, so that is my service also, service to the society.
So I think you are the happiest person in the world.
Really?
So I think you are the happiest person, sir.
May I ask
yes,
you?
Yes, definitely, definitely, sir. One minute, madam. So I share. Yeah. When we are getting, so when I was serving in the college, I used to get the salary. And the salary, it is nothing but the tax paid by the common man and received via government. I used to, that is, give benefit, deliver the goods to the students, friends, students, community, worth, and even more than the worth of the salary remuneration which I was getting, I was receiving. And even after retirement, the pension which I am getting, it is also a common man's tax which I am receiving, that is via government. Suppose I get a pension of rupees 30,000, each day it costs rupees 1,000. After retirement, so I could have get relaxed and I was I could have worked for my family only. But that pension which I am getting, it is a common man's tax, so I should serve the society. And so there is a worth rupees 1,000 every day. I should serve the society, and this is my there is a backdrop, and this is my the principle. So that is even after retirement. So I am working for the society in this that is backdrop.
Great deed, sir. Great deed.
Great deed.
Sir, when you told your memorable moment, I just had this thing in my mind, that is, Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara. Your students saw everything in you, and therefore they just can't, you know, they just couldn't believe that they are departing from you. And I'm touched by that memorable moment. Another thing is that whenever you are talking, I can see the clarity and precision, which makes the next man relieved of all the confusions. Another thing is that you have so much of human touch to everyone, that nobody want to go away. So this human touch and human resources that you recognize is really genius. Just connection to this, you are now a secretary of Karnataka Rajya Swakoshai Shikshan Samstha, Bangalore. And along with the other two designations of being secretary to Karnataka Swakoshai Samaj and the, you know, you are socially actively, you know, working in the field of society. So I just want to know, like, how you can handle all these things.
Madam, a lazy man never finds time. A busy man always finds time.
True.
Yeah, what is it?
Very yes.
Nice. And another there is a point I want to make it clarify. So when we chase excellence, success follows. So we should have there is willpower to serve the community. The community so to which we belong. And sense of belongingness is very much that is important. Sense of belongingness is very much required. And we should there is serve the samaja, serve the institution to which we belong. After retirement, there is I have been working for there is Karnataka Rajya Swakoshai Samaja as secretary. I have been working for that is a Karnataka Rajya Swakoshai Shikshana Samstha as a secretary, and I have been that is working for that is Gurupita Sthapana Samiti as a joint secretary.
May I disturb you, sir?
I coordinate. Yes, madam.
Just a small yes, thing. Madam? I have been to this Gurupita Sthapana function, and I saw tremendous crowd. And I was astonished, I was surprised and shocked to see the very good management there. And you just said that you are secretary there on this panel. And I really want to know more detail about this Guru Pitha program and you being the joint secretary there.
Yes. So we could, that is, make success because of that. There is the guidance, all the guidance given by Dhingaleshwar Swamiji, who is the pioneer and the great supporter in the establishment of our Guru Pitha Sthapana Samiti, Guru Pitha Sthapana. He helped us to search the Swamiji and identify the Swamiji and finalize the issue. That is, in all respect, he guided, and we could, that is, handle this program, and we could, that is, make success in the establishment of this Guru Pitha and Pattabhishekha, that is, coronation program. And now, so Guru Pitha, that is in, at Molkarmur, it is headed by Parama Pujya Shri Jiveshwarananda, that is Ananda Bharati Swamiji. So he was at, that is, Haridwara. He was there for 15 years. That is along with, that is, Babaji, Baba Ramdevji. He was working there. And now, so when, that is, we identified and we requested, that is, so he agreed, and his parents also agreed to give up. So there is a, as Swamiji to our Samaja, and for this Pattadhikari, there is a, the program that is called coronation program, we call it. So there is a, now, so there is a, this, that is a Pattabhishekha, after Pattabhishekha, the Guru Pitha is doing well. Yoga, there is classes are running, and there is a other, there is Homa, Havana, what we call, all the, there is puja functions are, there is taking place every, that is, morning and every evening. And Swamiji is addressing, there is the people who are visiting, that is, the Guru Pitha, and guiding very well. And they are taking the blessings of the Swamiji. And so it is going very well. And there is a long way to, there is a, the, go and the, achieve a lot. And Goshala is to be, there is established, and some other, there is institutions, Acharyakulam. There is Acharyakulam, there is an institution is to be established, and there is a lot of, there is works that have to be taken up in the due course.
Sir, I was present
in the Guru Pitha.
Sir, I was present.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so I met. Mrs. Aparna Nimkar is also present there, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, yes, yes.
It was God's grace. It was God's blessing that I was there and I could take the blessings of you all, great people. And it was really memorable moment in my life because I could meet our Adya Guru now and see the coronation with my eyes and the program that you arranged. It was really fabulous.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sir, actually, I ask one question you. You are joint secretary of, I'm sorry, you are secretary of Karnataka Rajya Sabhasali Shikshan Samstha. Can you tell me about this?
Yes, sir.
Last 1 to 2 days, I have just read your message, WhatsApp message.
Yeah.
I think this Samstha is doing a very good work, sir.
Yeah, sir. Immediately after retirement, that is, I shared my views with the, officials, that is, the committee. Bandari, Chandrakant Bandari sir is, that is, the president of this Samstha, and so I am secretary for it. And so there is, I shared my views to establish view of establishment of a separate, that is, a Shikshana Samstha for Sokulisali people in Karnataka, on par with, that is, KLE Society, which you may be knowing very well, which is working in Belgium, which is having its, that is, branches across the country and even there is abroad also. And so there's I thought of why should not we have this, the Shikshana Samstha for the Sokulisali people. And with this, that is, view, I shared and I spoke to, there is our executive committee members in Samaja, the Karnataka Rajya Sokulisali Samaja, and Karnataka Rajya Sokulisali Samaja executive committee members, they interested me. So you take up the, there is work and you prepare a report, how to establish it and what is the next process and all these, that is, the work should be taken by you only, they requested. And on their request, I started, that is, working out on it. I visited the different, that is, the management institutes, I interacted and I, there's a, took the help of, there's a bylaws from different, there is, managements, different societies, and I coordinated and I worked out a different that is bylaw set for there is our own that is Shikshana Samsthe Karnataka Rajya Swakoshala Shikshana Samsthe and I that is appealed all my that is the Swakoshala bandhus and lovers of that is Shikshana that is education and I presented the bylaws which I had prepared and it was approved and immediately after approval we went for registration. We got it registered in Bangalore. That is on 18th February, so 2016. On 18th February 2016. Now it is 4 years baby, and now we are there is a seeking membership from across the state, and even there is from the people who are there is abroad. It is doing well.
Very good.
सर आई वुड लाइक टू नो अबाउट द चेंजेस यू ब्रॉट इन दिस फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड पर्टिकुलरली द टीचिंग एंड लर्निंग प्रोसेस बिकॉज आई एम रियली वेरी क्यूरियस अबाउट टू कैन यू गिव वन एग्जाम्पल दैट वॉट सॉर्ट ऑफ टीचिंग मेथड we can implement in this today's COVID situation because we all are now working online so there are a lot of challenges in front of the teachers as well as the parents and the students and everyone is really worried about how the education will go on so can you help us to maintain this connectivity between the students and the teacher there
madam online that they're teaching cannot be so effective
right
compared to that is a face to face that is lecturing face to face that is a teaching
classroom teaching right
yes classroom teaching yeah, because we cannot read out their face the facial there is a effects of the students and how they react how they are that is interested so there is in hearing the lecture on online and so the better thing is instead of going in for that is online teaching make there is better to go in for the shift wise so wherein you have there is 40 there is students instead of there calling all the 40 students you call only there is 20 students so this for 3 days and the 3 days that is another 20 students that is so this is a better option so where we can give the deliver the goods to the students so online there is a teaching cannot be that effective and so we cannot make success in it we can comply with it that's all
yes there is no other source now to teach students right it is a good suggestion to shift have the shifting of the students as well as the teachers so that suggestion can be implemented there hopefully in the school let's look forward for that thank you sir
yes
it is sir I think you are staying in Bangalore itself na now
Right now, I am. There is a staying in Rani Bendur, sir. I came to Rani Bendur. There is, and so when I came to Rani Bendur, so I am under lockdown.
But I heard that you are staying at Bangalore, sir. No, sir.
I am. There is in Bangalore. I was there in Bangalore. And I used to there to travel, so my residence is in Rani Bendur, and many of the days I stay in Bangalore for samaja work and for Shikshana Samsthe work, and even that is for Karnataka Rajya Swakoshala Mahila Mandali. So the head office is there, and I used to there to assist them also for all the record maintaining and guidance.
Sir, how long it will take time to reach from Bangalore to Ranipur?
So for 4 hours by car. 4 hours by car.
4 hours by car. It means near about 200 kilometers, sir.
300 kilometers, sir.
300 kilometers. Oh, yeah. Sir. Last but important question: what is the message to all Sali community and other community and those who see us live?
So, there is appeal to Sokolo Bandhus in special and. Other community people in general, I want to give some messages, and I appeal also. Unless and until we toil and moil from dawn to dusk to better the life of the people, so we cannot achieve anything. That is, there is a saying, no sweat, no sweet. No sweat, no sweet. No pain, no gain. Okay. And therefore, so we have to work continuously to better the life, better the refinement of the lives in and around the person who is working. I appeal to love the samaja to which the people belong. Sense of belongingness is very much required nowadays. People neglect and they are indebted. They won't feel anything. So there is the feeling of delivering goods to the community to which he or she belongs should be there. Then only we can bring some, there is positive changes in the samaja. And we should work for the samaja or any organization that is with we attitude, because I attitude is a comedy. I attitude is a tragedy. You attitude is a comedy. We attitude is a remedy for all the issues which we come across. And therefore, we should develop we attitude and we can come out there is some with some solutions for the issues which we notice in functioning of the organizations. This is one aspect. Another one is we should work with the cool mind. We have to, we should be very patiently work for the organization, because we come across different people with different mindsets, and we should, there is a administer, we should hear the suggestions of the different people with the different mindsets, but we should take decision with that is cool mind. Dimag jiska ice, result uska nice. Work jiska par safalta mile sure. Therefore, our work should be pure, and we should work with cool mind. We get the success, and so we can, that is, refine society. We can build a steel strong society. We can build a steel strong organization also.
Right, that is what, sir, you have given us the very great message that we should unite together, and we must change the mindset, because we are always waiting for the sunrise, but it should not be there like that. The mindset can be there.
Madam, one point I want to share, right, in respect of for all the success journey, my better off, there is Rajeshwari, is very much, and he is a great partner.
Please call.
My wife.
Yes, sir. Yeah, definitely, sir.
Yes.
He's your better.
And because of her support, I could achieve so this much, and she supported in all respect, even after retirement also. And she is very much, that is, love the service to the community.
Sir, namaste.
So you are truly a friend, as well as a wife and a companion there.
Madam, because of her support, he Dhirendra, he is found in she, Rajeshwari. She. And Mr. Dhirendra, Mr. MR, Mr. Dhirendra is found Mrs. MRS, MRS, Mrs. Rajeshwari.
Wow.
And man Dhirendra, MAN, man Dhirendra is found in woman, Rajeshwari.
Right.
Yes, sir.
And male Dhirendra is found in female Rajeshwari.
Wow.
And this is so speaking, we are, sir, one, totally one.
Yeah.
Sir, really, really great, sir. Really, really proud of you, sir. And really, very, very proud of you, sir. Yeah, Aparna, end the program, please.
I felt like it is Shiva and Shakti together.
Yeah.
Right. That is Jiveshwara's origin, right?
So hats off to you, namaskara to you both. Thank you, ma'am, for coming and giving sir, this darshan.
Sir, we invite you our next World Study Foundation program. Sir, please do come. Marathra sir, please request. In your language, sir, please.
Sir, namaskar, sir. Dhirendra, sir. Oh, namaste, sir. Maruti, sir.
Please, in your language, sir.
Sir, namge Kannada nag maatada chance kodri, sir. Yeah, vanni. Yakandre ishto to English nag aitu.
Yes. Chenagidiri, sir. Chenagidiri.
Adu Kannada nag Telugu nag maatadidre nam kuda svalpa relax bartate.
Yes. Very good.
Very nice to you, sir. Bala santosha aitu ivaga. World Study Foundation meeting naga ನೀವು ಬಂದು ನಿಮ್ದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಜೆಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು ನಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಡರ್ಸ್
ಸೊ ನಾನು ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಈ ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ಉತ್ತಮ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೈತೆ ಅಂದಾಗ ಅದರ ಭಾಗಿದಾರ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಿ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಬೆಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ
ಸರ್ ನಾನು ಸಕಲ ಸಾಲಿ ಪರಿವಾರನಾಗ ನಿಮ್ದು ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಗಳು ನೋಡ್ತಿರ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಗಳು ಇರ್ತಾವ ಅಪ್ರಿಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಗಳು ಇರ್ತಾವ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಕೂಡ ನಿಮ್ದು ಅದು ಏನಂತಾರ ಕಾಂಟ್ರವರ್ಸಿ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ 100% ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿದಾಯಕ ಇರೋದಂಗೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ
ನಾವು So when we are eating bread out of common man's tax, whether in service or after retirement, service nalli irli, service nalli idda irli, retirement idre enattu, naavu padithakkanta adu so eno hana adu sarkaraddu, sarkaradinda samanya janaru kottidda tax andaga, naavu samanya janarige namminda yen aagtade adu kodbekalla, so aa nittinalli karyapravruttaragi kelasa maartta idavi, so eshtu namma kadinda saadhya aagtadano astu ಜನರಿಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೇದನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಸೊ ನಾನು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್
ಒಂದು ಹಮ್ಮೇನಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಮಂದಿ ರಿಟೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ರಿಟೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮನ್ಯಾಗ ಕುಂದಿರೋದು ಅವ್ರ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವ್ರದ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆನು ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಜನ ಬಹಳ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಸರ್ ಬಂದು ಸಮಾಜ ಸೇವಾ ಮಾಡೋದು ಇದು ಟೈಮ್ ಕೊಡೋದು ಈಗ ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀರಿ ಈಗ ರಾಣಿಬೆನ್ನೂರ್ನಾಗ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ ರಾಣಿಬೆನ್ನೂರ್ನಿಂದ ನೀವು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಮಂತ್ಲಿ ಟೂ ಟ್ವೈಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಓದ್ತಿರ್ತೀರಿ
ಈಗೇನ ಸರ ಈಗ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಎರಡು ಸಲ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಹೋಗಿ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಸರ ಮೊದಲು ಏನಿತ್ತು ನಾನು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಇರ್ತಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ ಸರ ಮೊಳಕಾಲ್ಮೂರು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಹುಬ್ಳಿ ಸೊ ಹೀಗನೆ ಅದೇ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು
ಸರ್ ಒಂದು ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಈಗ ನಮ್ದು ಸಕಲಸಾಳಿ ಸಮಾಜದ ಒಂದು ಗುರುಪೀಠ ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ನೀವು
ಹೌದು ಸರ್
ನಂದು ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಮಹಾಸ್ವಾಮಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಗಾಗ್ಲಿ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಊರಿಗಾಗ್ಲಿ ಒಂದ್ಸರ್ತಿ ನೀವು ಟೂರ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಚಲೋ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಎಂಬುದು ನಂದೊಂದು ಇಚ್ಛೆ
ಇದೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಸಜೆಷನ್ ಸರ್ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಸಜೆಷನ್ ಇದು ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಡ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್ ಇದು ಮಾರ್ತಿ ಸರ್
ಸರ್
ಇದು ಈಗ ಅದ ಇದು ಈಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನಾವು ಪಟ್ಟಾಭಿಷೇಕ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಪೂರ್ವದಲ್ಲಿನೇ ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದದ ಈ ಸದ್ಯ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಘಟಕದ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಘಟಕಗಳಿಗೆ ಭೇಟಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಸದ್ಯ ಏನು ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿದ ಹೊರತು ಬೇರೆ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಬಟ್ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅದ ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆನು ಭೇಟಿ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ವಿಚಾರಂಕರು ಐತಿ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಸರ್
ಬಟ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಒಂದೇ ಟೂರ್ ಇಡಬೇಡ್ರಿ ಸರ್ ಆಂಧ್ರ ತೆಲಂಗಾಣ
ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆನು ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆನು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಗೂ ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಗೂ ಭೇಟಿ
ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸರ್ ನನ್ ನೋಟಿಸ್ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೇನಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಗುರುಸ್ಥಾಪ ಗುರುಪೀಠಕ್ಕೆ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ದು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಐತೆ ಅಂತ ನನ್ಗೊಂದು ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಬಂದೈತೆ ಸರ್
ಹೌದು ಸರ್
ಆ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ನೀವು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದರದೊಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿ ಎಫ್ ಡಿ ಅಂತವು ಮಾಡಿ ಅದು ಯಾವಾಗನಾಗ್ಲಿ ರೊಕ್ಕದ ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ದಂಗ ನಡಿಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅದ್ರಿಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ ಸರ್ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ರೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ರೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಸ್ವಾಮಿಯವ್ರಿಗೆ ಎರಡು ಮೂರು ದಿವಸ ಇದ್ದು ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ಪ್ರವಚನ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವ್ರಗಳಿಂದ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ ಅಂಬುದು ನನ್ನೊಂದು ಭಾವನೆ ಇದೆ ಸರ್.
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು ಹೌದು, ಅದೇ ಅದೇ ವಿಚಾರದಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಘಟಕಗಳಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಭೇಟಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಒಂದು ಯೋಜನೆ ಐತರ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಘಟಕಗಳಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಭೇಟಿ ಕೊಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನ್ ಸರ್
ಸರ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್
ಏನ್ ಸರ್
ಅಪರ್ಣ
I am very very thankful for being here present online session on Mr. Marathrao Sakre. Thank you very much for being here with us, and I am really thankful to Mr. Dhirendra Ekbote sir for being with us. And the most important message that we received from him is to be humble, to have all the emotions present, feel them, have the affect present in life so that you can make the life beautiful, and also be human to the people around us, serve the society and be there a part of it. I'm really thankful for being here and really thankful for blessing us and sharing a lot of things with us. We learned a lot of things with you and your conversation. I'm really thankful on behalf of WSF, that is WSI Foundation, and I hand over all the thanks.
Sir, very very thank you by behalf of all World Sadi Foundation.
Vijay sir,
interview team, so Pratiksha Bolde, Aparna Nimkar, Sanjay Sadi, Varsha Pargat, and Rajesh Tambre and Mr. Marathrao Sakre. Thank you once again. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra, Jai Jiveshwar. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Sir, Vijay sir. Vijay sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Vijay sir.
Yes.
Vijay sir. So yes, today. Sir. For me, today is a tasty Tuesday. Tasty Tuesday. Every day is a special.
Yes, sir.
Word. Marvelous Monday. Tasty Tuesday. Wonderful Wednesday. Thankful Thursday. Friendly Friday. Successful Saturday. Super Sunday. What a great week it is. Among these, there is 7 days of the that is a week. So today is a tasty Tuesday, and I cherished it. I tasted it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.